numbers on sunscreens. 25, 45, 50, and 110. Is SPF 100 the double the effect of SPF 50? Sunscreen with UV camera.
Whoa! I gotta draw a smiley face.
Hey guys, welcome back to Beauty Facts Unboxing, it's Casper. In our last episode, we talked all about those weird but clever looking hacks you find on the internet, and I asked you guys if you guys have tried out these weird hacks, and more of you guys said yes than no. Today's topic is sunscreen. Sunscreen is a must all year round, but the season is coming where sunscreen is even more important. Today, using a UV camera, we're actually going to answer some questions you guys may have about sunscreens. Is SPF 50 double the effect of SPF 25? So you've seen all these numbers on sunscreens, right? 50, 45, 20, 30, etc, etc. Does that mean that higher the number, the more effective the sunscreen is? First, let's figure out what the difference of these numbers actually mean. So here we have three physical sunscreens with three different SPFs. We've brought SPF 25, SPF 45, and SPF 50+. We're going to get the exact same amount of each product and test out what the difference is. Okay, I'm gonna start with SPF 25. Ooh, it looks all white in the camera, okay. And then I'm gonna go in with SPF 45 here. Okay, this one's like really watery, guys. Okay, so the 25 looks really white and this one looks a little bit darker. It actually just kind of looks like my skin tone. I'm gonna go in with SPF 50+ now. Oh, even on camera, this doesn't really look, this actually looks kind of dark. Okie dokes. Whoa, it's like a gradation. It almost looks like those eyeshadows, you know, the ones that like blend in like this. So you can tell that there isn't a really big difference here, but it's this one that's really different. So it seems that the higher the SPF, the darker the color is. There wasn't a big difference between these two, 45 and 50+. They kind of had a darkish grayish hue, while the 25 was actually really bright. So I'm guessing, you know, more protection if higher the SPF, which is what SPF is, right? Sun protection factor. I'm actually gonna do some research on this. So let's say sunlights come in numbers. SPF 25 sunscreens reduces those sunlights into 1, so it blocks the rest of 24. If we calculate it, SPF 25 blocks 24 out of 25, so it blocks about 96%. SPF 50 will reduce 50 into 1, so 49 out of 50, which means it blocks 98%. So the difference between SPF 50 and SPF 25 is 2%. The UV blockage does not increase in proportion to the value of SPF, but when the SPF values are higher, the blocking effect is higher. For daily use, SPF 30 is plenty, but if you plan on staying outside a lot, then SPF 50 or over is recommended. Why can't I apply sunscreen right before going outside? I'm sure you guys have heard by now that you're not supposed to apply sunscreen right before you leave the house. Like you're supposed to apply it 30 minutes before. Did you guys know that there are two big categories when it comes to sunscreen? Physical and chemical. Today we're going to try applying both of these categories and see where the whole you can't apply sunscreen before going outside came from. So we have two types of sunscreens here today, and just like before, we're going to get the same amount for the experiment. So I'm going to apply the physical sunscreen first. Okay, you can see that this part of my arm looks really dark where I applied the physical sunscreen. As you can see, the shade is similar to the previous experiment, and it's similar to my skin color. Now I'm gonna apply the chemical sunscreen. Whoa, what is that? It's like, whoa! Oh my gosh, I'm gonna draw a smiley face. Whoa! It's like ink. More smiley face. Wow, 진짜 신기하다. You guys see that? Oh my gosh, it looks like I have a black arm tattoo. Wow. How is it that they're both sunscreens but they look so different? Let's find out why this is happening by visiting a Wish company staff who develops and researches products. So we've arrived at the headquarters. Let's go inside.
두 제품의 UV 차단 방식이 달라서 그렇게 보이는 거거든요. 이것처럼 까맣게 보이는 제품은 빛을 다 흡수를 하는 성질 때문에 우리 눈에는 까맣게 보이는 거고, 또 하얗게 보이는 거는 모든 빛을 반사를 해서 하얗게 보이는 거거든요. 자외선을 모두 흡수를 하는 유기 자외선 차단제 같은 경우에는 UV 카메라로 봤을 때 아마 색깔이 까맣게 보이셨을 거예요. 피부의 도포가 돼서 흡수가 되는 시간, 그리고 자외선 차단제가 피부에서 작용하는 시간이 조금 필요해서 외출하기 한 15분에서 30분 전에 미리 발라주시라고 요청을 드리는 것도 같은 이유입니다. 유기 자외선 차단제랑은 다르게 피부에 도포했을 때 피부 위에 얇은 막을 형성을 해서 피부에 올라오는 UV를 반사를 시키는 역할을 해주는 자외선 차단제예요. 그래서 무기 자외선 차단제 같은 경우에는 바로 도포가 되자마자 자외선을 튕겨낼 수 있는 능력이 있기 때문에 외출하기 직전에 바르셔도 괜찮은 제품입니다.
Oh, okay. So applying sunscreen 30 minutes before going outside is only applicable to chemical sunscreens. So if you're in a hurry, then you can go for physical sunscreens and you'll be all set. After applying these sunscreens, I felt definite differences between the two different types, not only from the UV camera, but from what I felt as I was applying them. Chemical sunscreen felt hydrating and transparent on the skin, while the physical sunscreen kind of had a slight white cast and it had a tone up effect. Because I have dry skin, I actually prefer the chemical sunscreen more, but depending on what type of skin type you have, you can pick which one you prefer. How much sunscreen do you need to apply on your face? There are a lot of different opinions on this. Some people say like a coin amount, some people say two fingertips amount. I don't know, I want to know the exact amount. Since this seems to be so unclear, I decided to do some research on this. So, 2 milligrams per centimeter squared. What does that even mean? So this is why I prepared these. 36 centimeter squared cotton pad, 9 centimeter squared cotton pad, and 1 centimeter squared cotton pad soaked up in toner to measure the centimeter squared of my face. With that, we could figure out how much sunscreen I will need to apply on my face. This is gonna feel like getting a facial, guys. Like a skin mask. It's like playing Tetris on my face. So I'm gonna count these out to figure out how big my face is in centimeter squared. Producer, help me.
So my face is 273 centimeters squared, which equates to, times 2, 546 milligrams. So that means I need to apply 0.54 grams of sunscreen on my face. So applying the adequate amount of sunscreen is very important. This is more than I would normally put on my face. So it's taking a little more time to fully get it in there. Wow, so even for just the face, an adequate amount is quite a bit of sunscreen. So to be honest, the recommended amount felt a little bit too much on my skin.
But I think it'd be better to be safe than sorry, so apply a little bit more than normal on your face to get the proper UV protection. Today on Beauty Facts Unboxing, we answer some questions that you guys might have had about SPF. I've learned so much through these experiments, so I hope that you learned something out of it too. Sunscreen is something that we use every single day, but we might not exactly have the correct ideas about, so I think this video would be really helpful. These days, you see a lot of base makeup products like foundation, BB cream, cushion foundations with SPF in them, but the SPF in these products is not enough for the daily application. The reason for this is you do not apply enough and adequate amount of these products on your face. Remember guys, the amount was quite a lot for our skin, right? You don't apply that much of cushion foundation or BB cream on your face, which is why you need to apply SPF separately. So then, question here. Would you get the SPF 50 effect by applying an SPF 30 sunscreen and an SPF 20 primer? Yes or no? If you watch the video properly, you guys will have the correct answer to this, so please participate in our questionnaire. We'll let you know the answer in the next episode of Beauty Facts Unboxing. So thank you guys again for joining in with me and my fun experiments, and I'll be back with another interesting video. If you guys have further questions or experiments you guys want me to test out, then please leave them down in the comments below. Subscribe, like, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye guys!